Let's calculate the mean. We can do this in the usual way. Let's sum up the observations and multiply by 1 over how many there are. Or in other words, sum together the observations and divide by how many there are. Okay, so multiplying by the reciprocal is the same as dividing by n. The observations are denoted by x subscript 1, which is 1, x subscript 2, which is 3.7, and x subscript 3, which is 2.9, for a total of 3 observations, n equals 3. In this case, 1 plus 3.7 plus 2.9 divided by 3 gives 2.53 approximately, because the real answer is 2.53333. So make sure you can compute that in your calculator. X bar, or little x bar, can be written another way. We can write it as reflected in the symbols here. This symbol for summation says add up all the x's. There's 3 x's in our case, but in general we use the symbol n. So you add up from index I equals 1 to n all the x's, and then you multiply by 1 over n, which is really the same as dividing by n. And this gives you little x bar. Since for the sample mean, you will always be summing up little n observations and subsequently dividing by n for the number of observations, we don't actually have to write the indices here, I equals 1 to n. We can just write the symbol like this. Okay? This symbol is sigma in Greek. It's capital S, capital sigma in the Greek alphabet, and it represents S for summation. So if ever you see the symbol and forget, hopefully you can recall that this is the Greek letter S for sum, and you know what to do. So in this case, I'm telling you to sum up the x's and divide by n. Anytime you see this sort of set of operations, summing and then dividing by how many there are, this is just a mean, okay? And you'll see what I mean about this in a subsequent slide. Okay, so let's do the same calculation of the mean, but in our calculators using stat mode. Okay, what do I mean by stat mode? I mean that we're going to enter the values and the calculator is going to store them like in a spreadsheet, and then all the statistical operations available on your calculator can be performed on the stored values. To use stat mode, if you have the TI-30XA that I recommended students buy, identify the symbol sigma on your calculator. In particular, there's a plus beside it. Okay, so locate that on your calculator. We're going to use it to enter our values. Alright, let's begin entering values. The first observation is 1. We're going to enter into our calculator the value 1, and then we're going to hit the summation plus button. Let's do that together. And what you'll see is on your screen, it says n equals 1. You see your calculator is keeping score, keeping track of how many observations you've entered. So far you've entered 1, so the sample size is 1. Also on your screen, there is the word stat at the top, indicating that you have activated stat mode. Let's enter the next value, which is 3.7. 3.7, summation. Okay, And now your screen indicates n equals 2, because you have two values in the stat mode of your calculator. The final value, the final observation is 2.9. Let's enter that into the calculator with summation mode after, or summation plus after. And now we have three values, and the screen reflects the fact that we have three values in the stat mode. So now at our disposal are all of the functions for statistics in the calculator, which can be activated using the second function button. So if you hit the second function key, which is in yellow, and ask for x bar, which is above the x squared key, right in the third row middle. So what you're going to want to do is hit second, and then the yellow key, well, it's actually above a key, but it indicates that key is used for x bar. So after you do that, you get the value 2.53 repeating. So the bar on top indicates that the 3 repeats. So that would be your answer. And why would we do this? Well, if there were more values than just 3, you can imagine entering the values and making a mistake at some point is much more likely, unless you use the stat mode. With the stat mode, you can keep track of how many you've entered and notice if you missed one or made an error, and correct it. Okay, because even though you make a mistake entering in a value, you can clear the screen yet not clear the memory of all the other values you entered. So this is using stat mode. One last point. If you want to clear your calculator of the memory of the values you've entered, you can either turn off your calculator or hit second CSR. CSR is above 7. So you could hit second to clear stat mode, and you'll know it's clear because there's no longer the word stat on the top of the screen. You can hit second and then CSR, which is above the 7 key. Okay. The other way is simply to turn off the calculator. And when you want to use it again, turn it back on.